Hallelujah. If that hand is for Jesus, can we give a louder hand to King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Okay, I'm very sure the one you gave is for me. Can we do the one that we are going to give to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Amen. Amen. Actually, in the church I pastor, when we say let's give it to King of Kings, we don't sit to give hands to King of Kings. We stand to give hands to the King of Kings. So let's stand and give hands to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 What a privilege to be in your midst this evening. Wednesday, my phone was off. I think it was on Friday evening. The pastor was trying to contact me. He wasn't able to contact me. So the minute I switched on the phone, I saw his message. He said, Christian, you are coming on Saturday to preach. I didn't want to give him any reasons why I won't be able. I left KL Wednesday to have some time with some of my leaders. We prayed all through. Came back Friday, tired. We had Destiny Night last night till early hours of the morning, 4. So I was having a lot of reason in my head. But I said, there are some people you don't say no to. It's like Papa calling you, hey, come down to Moa. I say, Papa, I've got some things to do. You dare not say such things. Glory be to God. Amen. I trust God that this evening is going to be an exciting evening for all of us. Amen. Trust God so much. I thank the set man who gave me the opportunity to stand and minister to you. And I thank Holy Spirit for what he's about to do right now this evening in this place. Lord, I ask that your sovereign hand move in the midst of your people. Let the voice of God be heard in the temple. Let the voice of man cease. Let Jesus Christ be seen and let his manifest presence be revealed in our midst. Let the thought of the Father engulf our mind and our thought in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we declare that it is you who will reign and rule in this place. There is no other God but you. Let the authority of the Father be seen and your people will celebrate you and glorify you. If you believe it, let me hear your better amen. Thank you. You may be seated in God's presence. A lot of thoughts was going on in my mind when worship was going on. How 2016 came, and in a split of second, looks as if to say 2016 did not exist. Some had some plan. I will do this in October. I will do this one in August. I will do this one in May. By May, it looks as if to say it wasn't achievable. Okay, let me shift it to July. July, August, September. Okay, November, December. All right, let me see how it's going to be in 2017. That's how people live their life. When our sister was leading the worship, her opening statement is that mind of people were like, 2016 is very tough. The economy of the world is so bad. Ringgit has fallen so bad. Those in importation and business and all kinds of things, we can't do it anymore. We are stressed. We stay in the comfort of our house. We complain about the government. Najib is crazy. Why is he not doing this? Why is he not doing that? Why has things gone so bad? But can we make a little U-turn tonight and have a change of mind of who you are? Yeah. Are you getting what I'm saying? Yes. Can I tell you the truth? Yes. Economy of the world will not get better. The economy of the world, it will not do what? Get better. My father used to tell me, there was a time one naira is equal to $1. There was a time one naira is equal to £1. You know, that was what the prophet was saying in the Bible.
We are tired of hearing, oh God, we have heard our father have this, you have done this in the days of our fathers. Do what you want to do in our own day. Not the one you did in the days of our father. Are you following me this evening? Because something needs to shift in our mind for us to assess 2017, take it and make very use of it. If not, it will just be like, when the time for you to take stock of 2017, you're like, what happened again? And one is wasting his years. It was that bad in Hebrews chapter 1, verse 12, I think verse 11. They began to pray, God, let our year not fail. In other words, there are some people that their year used to fail. You don't get what I'm saying? Let's take it in Hebrew. It's not part of the message. Hebrews chapter 1. Look at verse 12, the last line. Okay, let's read for the whole verse 12. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 12. Like a cloak, you will fold them up, and they will be changed. But you are the same, and your years will not fail. My own translation said, your year will not do what? Fail. In other words, there are people who their years do fail. So it depends on how you walk through that year that will make the year to be what? Productive or counterproductive. Am I talking to somebody this evening? She said, before her baby came, she made a preparation. Where the baby will go to school. What kind of food they will eat. Probably what kind of friends they will keep. Because her eye will be on the baby to check. This kind of friend, I don't want this kind of friend around you. If we are careful to make those preparations for our children, why are we not making preparations for our life as we step into every year? And we just allow the year to pass by without making any meaningful effort throughout that very year. And then at the end of it all, we begin to complain to God or complain to the pastor. I don't know what has happened to me. Did you make preparation? You want to build a condominium. You don't want to do a lot of excavation and do a lot of piling. Yet you want to build a condominium. How will it stand? Am I talking to somebody? Am I talking to somebody at all? Yes. Respond so that I know you are responding. The kind of foundation they use in building condominium that will be up to 100, it will be different from the one that will only be 10. Is it true? Yes. You don't waste your raw material putting the kind of foundation you know that the building will carry only 10. When you know that the building will carry only what? 10. When it's going to carry 100, you put a lot of material to have capacity to carry what you are building. Until there is a capacity build up inside of you, you will see what you are looking for. Are you getting what I'm saying? If you want this year to be what you desire it to be in this January, start to develop capacity that will produce what you desire in 2017. Am I talking to somebody at all? That's how people builders build. We see natural things. We think those natural things are different from the spiritual things. I'm preaching this evening what I titled The Thinking Pattern of a Blessed Man. The Thinking Pattern of a blessed man. Mommy said something that excited me. I quickly wrote it down for my personal consumption. I don't know whether you got it when she said it, but I quickly wrote it down. He said, it is not 2017 that is going to change. It is us that need to change. I quickly wrote it down immediately because that was prophetic. That was accurate. That was what we need to do. It is not the year that we adjust. God has set in place all that will happen in 2017. I am the one that need to align myself, adjust myself to fit into God's plan and purpose for those things to come to pass. Am I talking to you at all? It's not 2017 that need to change. Everything that will happen in 2017, they have been set in motion. Those who will die, will die. Those who will give birth to children, will give birth to children. Those who God wants to prosper, they will prosper. All you need to do is to fine-tune your frequency to God. Do we have things like radio station in Malaysia? Television station in Malaysia? As we are here now, do you agree that frequencies are passing? Yes. True of us? Yes. Frequencies are what? Yes. So if I have my little radio, when I tune into 93.5, if there is a station that is 93.5, accurately, I will begin to download what is happening in that station. True of us? Yes. If I don't tune very well, 93.45, I may be hearing, but there's a lot of noise at what? At the background. That's how people's ear will be in 2017. When you tune accurately, you will hear accurately. Things will work accurately. When you don't fine tune very well, a lot of noise will be at the background. Destruction. What is going on? Why is others breaking forth and you are not breaking forth? Before we go to 2017, Papa has given a prophetic declaration that the portal is open. That we need to launch it into the portal. How can you have a portal that is open and you are struggling? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't what? It doesn't what? Make sense. If your spiritual father prophesied that the portal is open, that we need to launch in immediately and connect what is in heaven, bring it down on earth. We don't need to struggle at all in 2017. When others are complaining, you are not permitted to do what? Complain. Because you are connected to a portal that men are not connected to. If you are the one I'm talking, let me hear your better amen. Connected. But I just want to deal with something this evening. The thinking pattern of a blessed man. A man that is blessed of God have a way they think. The guy who designed this instrument, there was something he was thinking before he put it together. The mic I'm holding, the guy who did it, there was something he was thinking before he knew how to use this implement to amplify the voice of an individual. Proverbs said something in Proverbs chapter 23 verse 7. As a man thinketh in his what? Heart. So is what? He. As a man does what? Thinketh. So is he. As a man, somebody say with me, as a man. Thinks. So is he. As a woman. Thinks. So he sees. You know, when we say only a man, people will think women are removed from that part of the scripture. They are included. As any human being thinks in life, so would that person be. So something goes on in this mind that if they are not adjusted to the frequency of Jehovah and you begin to pick vibration from another frequency that is wrong, all you see through this year will be evil. Can I tell you something that will shock you? Since you were born, there has been an over and over bad news. Bad news will not stop coming. Yeah. What happens in life is what you make use of those news they are hearing. When they bring the news, say, not for me. I know I have a better destiny more than this one you are bringing. I'm connected to a portal that will not fail. This one is not for me. Ringgit is failing. It's not your problem. You are not the one controlling it. God is in the midst of it all. Why did the Bible say that all things work together for good to them that love God? No matter how the tide goes, you will get to your destination. I can't hear you. I say, no matter how the tide goes, you will get to your destination. If you're that one, let me hear your better amen.
In my church, when I say, if you're that one, let me hear your better amen, they say, amen. Amen means, let it be so.
So if you're that one, let me hear your better amen. Amen.
So that I feel that I'm at home. Sometimes if I want them to really understand how serious it is, I say, give me three amen. They give me amen, amen, and amen. So I know that they are getting what I'm saying.
Are we together this evening?
Yes.
So if we close the service by 12 midnight, is he okay? I'm just joking. The thinking pattern of a blessed man. Any man that must think, I will try to see if I can teach. Any man that must be blessed by God must think and reason like your creator. Any man that must be blessed by God must think, reason like what? Your creator. Natural parents will see children and they say, this one is behaving like me. Mothers, you understand what I'm saying? Between mother and the father, when a child is not behaving well, the mother will say, this one is behaving like the father. If it is the father, this one is behaving like the mother. Does it happen in Asia?
Yes.
Does it happen in Africa? I'm very sure. If I do something very nice, my mom will say, wow, that's my son. If I do the one that is wrong, my father will say, you behave like your mother. Good report, mother's take. Bad report is for the fathers. I hear you. But the truth of the matter, you cannot win them in that game. Because parents, the fathers will go and are busy with the assignment, and the mothers are the one taking care of them. Glory be to God. When you think you want to receive what the father have in stock for you, you must think like your creator. That's the first thing you must have at the back of your mind. You can't be thinking like a goat and expect to get a miracle like a human being. You don't get what I'm saying? How can you be thinking like an animal and want to have a result of those who are thinking like humans? You are not a goat. You are a man. The reason why God created you and gave you supernatural wisdom is He elevated you above other animals so that you will reason like him, think like him, walk like him, talk like him, produce what he produced. Why are you using your mind to talk like an animal instead of a man? Have you ever seen a monkey that produced a goat? Have you ever seen? Have you ever seen a lizard that produced a lion? Is it possible? Why is it, man, that we that is created in the image of God, we are producing far below the standard of our creator? He created a male and female in his what? Image. Until your mind picks what he picks, you can't produce what he produces. Until your mind see what God sees, picks what God picks, you can't produce what God produces. For any man or woman that will bet God kinds of result on earth must think. Think, reason, and produce like your father. I get what I'm saying. God said that the portal is open. He said, which portal? Ring gate is falling left, right, and center and say, somebody is telling me that the portal is open. Papa, are you out of your mind? Are you getting what I'm saying? That's what people do. Portal is open. Men are going to crossing to get all that they desire in God. Papa, can't you check the ring gate? Are you not seeing the house rent is increasing? Can't you see there's increments in school fees? Petrol price is increasing. Can't you see I can't even sell anything? And you're saying 2017 will be better. No. There is what he's seeing that you're not seeing. You need to adjust your eyes to see what he's seeing so that he will produce the sound he's producing. When you see differently, you talk differently. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You cannot be talking when you are not seeing something that is different. Men talk for the volume of their sight and the capacities of their life. I say, men do what? Talk by the volumes and the capacity of their what? Sight. You can bring a man here when all these things are not put in place. Say, can this place be beautified nicely so that it looks like a church? He said, no, this is nonsense. This place cannot fit very okay. He cannot see. Then somebody will come in and say, wow, this is awesome. It is wonderful. I can put this here. I can put this here. I can put this here. It means that individual have what they call what? Creative what? Imagination. Somebody say creative imagination. You are not talking to me. Do we end the service? Creative imagination. It can see things from where men cannot see things. That's why we have a friend called Holy Spirit. He shows us what others don't see. Remember the song we sang? I don't live by what? Didn't we sing that song together? Why are you not responding? But when we go to coffee shop, as we are eating, we make more noise. When we come to church, we don't talk very well. I don't live by what I what?
See.
The best place to make the loudest noise is in the church. One day we are doing vigil in the night and policemen came and said, why are you now noise so loud? I say, because this is church. We make noise to our Creator. You know, when we worship, we wave our hands to heaven. The reason why we make noise and scream, because we know he's alive. He hears us. We are not like those who go to temple and then they are so quiet, they don't make noise to their Creator. We make noise to our Creator because he hears our voice when we make a noise. Am I talking to somebody this evening? Let's continue. I've just given you only principle number one. Those who think like God are bound to have God's kind of result. Think like God and produce God's result. Until your thought and your thinking pattern reflect his, you can't see what he sees, nor know what he knows. Jeremiah chapter 22, verse 11. I know the thought. Somebody say, I know. I know. I know the thought I have for you. I know. Somebody say, I know.
I know.
I know.
I
can't hear you. I know.
I know.
I won't stop saying it until you get it. I know.
I know.
I know.
I know.
The thought I have for you.
I have for you.
In other words, he's not confused about his thought for you.
Amen.
Until you live in the place of knowing, you'll be walking around the earth like a confused man. Stop living like a man who are doing guesswork. Live like individual who know.
Yes.
Am I talking to somebody this evening?
Yes.
We don't live like men who do guesswork. We live like men who do what? Know. The reason you live is because you know him. The reason why 2017 will be successful, because you know prophetic word has gone ahead. You know, you know. Am I talking to somebody this evening? Somebody say, I know. I can hear you. I know. I believe. I believe 2017 will be better for me. Live like someone who knows. Stop living like men who don't know. Men who know get to their destination.
Yes.
Those who don't know, look for GPS. Sometimes GPS will take you to the wrong address. I get what I'm saying? Have you seen a blind man who is depending upon another Ben, come. Let me use you. Close your eyes. You want to go there. That's where you go. But close your eyes. You are going there. You are going there. In his mind, he believed, I'm taking him there. But I'm the one who decide where he is going. So he's depending his life on me. Because he don't know. He don't have sight to see where he's going. Thank you. As God's children, we don't need to behave or live that way. We must live like men who know where we're going. We know our destination. We know our address. And you will get there in the name of Jesus. You know, babies, little children, they depend on the father to know what they feel. Am I making any sense at all? Yes. When a baby is small, when the baby cries, the mother knows whether he has poo-poo to change the diapers. If he cries, this cry may be he's sick, he needs a doctor. Yeah. If he cries, this cries that he needs food to do what? To eat. That's what? Baby. Somebody said that's for what?
Baby.
That's for what?
Baby.
But when you grow up, when you are hungry, you know you are hungry. You go to the place where you do what? Get food. Yes. Through of us.
Yes.
Are you agreeing with me at all?
Yes.
When you want to drink water, you know water. And you take water and do what? Drink. But a baby does not have that ability. Now, why are we adults in God still living like a baby? Every year we cry and we expect maybe, Pastor, tell me whether it's water we drink. The other day you cry, Pastor, come and change my diaper. No. Say your neighbor, grow up. I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, grow up. I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, grow up. There is a need for us to mature in God and change our thinking what? Pattern. Know what you want. Go for what you want in God and God will make it happen. Can I hear your better amen?
You're
not a baby anymore. Babies are fed with milk. Mature men in God are fed with what? Meat. You're not a baby. Your mindset must change. For you to be able to take the territory and city for God. Can I hear your better amen?
Amen.
Can I hear your better amen?
Amen?
Let's look at another principle. The mind of God is totality of his will. Until your mind is renewed to become like that of God, you will be operating like a car without an engine or a fuel. The mind of God is totality of God's will. When this, your mind is not renewed and transformed, you will be like a car, moving, parked. And men will think there is an engine there. There is no engine. There is no fuel. Year in, year out, you are parked in the same position. The same level you are in 2013, that same level you are in 2014, that same level in 2015, same level in 2016. And then you want to enter into 2017 with the same attitude. Somebody say minus me. Somebody say minus me.
Minus me.
I can't hear you. Somebody say minus me.
Minus me.
Use your mouth, say minus me.
Minus me.
What do I mean by minus me? I don't want you to be added to the people who are living that kind of recycled lifestyle. Something must be different in your life. Something must be different in your life. Something must be what? Different. Something must be what? Different. You know what I discovered about Christians of our generation? We do so much talking, we don't think. Tell your neighbor, we do so much talking. We don't think. True of us? True of us? You don't believe me? Check yourself. Before even you came to service, how many talk you have done? Any of them, is there any thinking out of them? Like parrot. Nobody's thinking. Anytime economy of the earth goes bad, is an opportunity for God, creating for his people, for them to rise. You don't believe me? Anytime the economy of the earth is going down, left, right, and center, is an opportunity for God's people to do what? Rise. Anytime you see economy of the earth going down, God is setting men up because it need to go down for some men to rise. Oh, I don't know how to say it for you to believe me. Money or wealth do not travel out of planet earth. Money is not money? Yeah. Like a flight. They don't travel out of planet Earth. This one is not MH370 that they didn't discover. But money, they move from this location to another location. Yeah. Proverbs said that they have wings. They fly to get to where those who are ready and prepared to receive them. How prepared are you to change your economic status? How prepared are you to change your spiritual status? How prepared are you to make your marriage better? How prepared are you to make your academics better? What are you prepared to make better in your life in 2017? Preparation is what? When preparation meets opportunity, becomes breakthrough. When a man is not prepared, off preparation plus off preparation equals to failure in life. Zero preparation multiplied by zero preparation equals to what? Zero. Can I give you that formula again? Formula for failure. Zero preparation multiplied by what? Zero preparation equal to what? Zero. Preparation multiplied by what? Preparation equals what? Breakthrough. Until you are prepared, your environment will not respond to you.
Yeah.
Friends, even those we call unbelievers, they work hard. Those you think that they don't know, they do what? Work hard. You have additional privilege more than them. Why are you not utilizing it? You have Holy Ghost. Because a man who prepared and worked hard, and Holy Ghost show you where to put your resources, you will break forth faster than them. Because you see what they don't see. Now you see and you relax. No, they don't see. They work hard and they meet it. By luck. You don't get what I'm saying? They don't see. They prepare. And they believe, let me be working hard. Somewhere along the line, things will turn right for me. And somehow, God, who has arranged things to be, will allow them by grace, they will meet it. But you have heard that the portal is open. You say, Papa has said it, it's settled. Yes. What are you doing to walk into it? Say with me, in 2017, I won't be a lazy bone. I can't hear you. I won't be a lazy bone. If you're not responding, I know you're a lazy bone. I won't be a lazy bone. In 2017, I will change my thinking. I will believe God. I will work towards his plan. Because I'm going to be great in 2017. If you're that one, let me hear your better amen. And you are going to be that one in the name of Jesus Christ. Thinkers rule the world. Thinkers rule the world. Those who can think, they control what goes on in the world. Thinkers travel far in life, farther than those who are talkers. Thinkers rule the world. Those who can think control what goes on in the world. They travel farther in life more than talkers. So help me tell your neighbor, add to your talking, thinking. You didn't say what I said. Tell your neighbor, add to your talking. Add to your talking, thinking. Mama, you understand what I'm saying? Mama is the only person that is responding very well since I started preaching. God bless you, Mama. Let's give a hand of a clap to Mama. Seriously, I've been observing her. She's the one responding very well, more than every other. Because, you know, in their age, what they are not able to do, they desire that the generation coming behind them will do it better. Tell your neighbor again, add to your talking. Thinking. Stop talking too much. Think too much. Somebody's not responding. Stop talking too much. Think too much. Thinkers, they control the world. Talkers, they don't have any business to control the world. The only people that is permitted to talk is people who talk like I'm preaching. If your job is not in preaching or talking, stop talking, start thinking. If I catch you talking in 2017, when you don't have any job, we're talking business, I will ask pastor to flog you 6 strokes of cane. So you need to be what? Thinking, not talking. The year is not a talking year. It is a year you will hide yourself under the cleft of Jehovah and begin to think so that you will produce supernatural results. Can I hear your better amen? Amen. Sir, I'm here to see talkers who control the world. Men who put their brain to work. With the help of Holy Spirit are the one who control what goes on in the world. I see you rising as that one in the name of Jesus Christ. I see you rising as the one who will control the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, I will rise. I will rise to be a creative thinker. I will think by the help of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit will give me energized communication that will produce kingdom result for me in 2017. I will rise to be great. I won't fail like I fell in 2016. This year shall be like a year like no other for me. If you believe, let me hear your loud amen. 2017 must be different year for you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Thinkers rule and dominate the world. Add to your talking, thinking. Add to your what? Talking what? Thinking. Add to your talking what? Thinking. How many of you have your bedroom? You have a bedroom in your house? How many of you have bedroom? How many of you have a portion where you call eating room, where you eat? How many of you? How many of you have dining room? How many of you have sitting room? Sitting room is actually talking room, where you talk with CNN 24 hours of the day. How many of you have talking room? You have talking room. How many of you have office where you work? You have your office. How many of you have thinking room? Thinking room in your house. How many? How many have thinking room in their house? No thinking room. Huh? Sister? No thinking room. We have talking room. We have eating room. We have bedroom. We have all kinds of room. But there is only one room that makes men great in life. We don't have it. It is called what? Thinking room. Tell your neighbor, thinking room. In 2017. I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, in 2017, create thinking room in your house. You don't need to go and rent another additional apartment. All you need to do, get a table and a chair. Keep it one side of that your bedroom. Shut all the noise. Sit on that table with a paper. Anytime you call your thinking room, shut down your phone. Go there. Think. Sit on that table and begin to do what? Think. Sit there and do what? Think. As you continue to think under the influence of Holy Spirit, ideas will be coming. Write them down. They are those ideas are the trade secret that makes men great in life. Am I talking to somebody at all?
Yes.
Get yourself a thinking room. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Please don't get this one I'm going to say out of context. You have prayed enough. Start thinking. Add to your prayer, thinking. Add to your prayer, meditation. That's what I mean by thinking. You have been praying and praying and praying without meditation. So add in 2017 to your prayer, meditation. What prayer does is to open up the atmosphere for you so that you'll be able to be downloading data from heaven. Now, when you pray and the time for you to begin to download data, you walk out of the praying room. That's what we do. So how will God respond? Am I talking to somebody? In 2017, whether you are in form one or form two, whether you are a baby or not, create time for what? Thinking, meditation. So in Genesis, Bible said, there was famine in the land. And somebody went to the field. When he finished meditation, he went and planted vineyard. And suddenly thereafter, he reaped 100-fold. You can't be a man of meditation and will not be taking inspiration from heaven. You can't sort the noise that is distracting you right, left, and center and won't pick anything from heaven. You are praying. Suddenly, somebody said, what's up? Hi. You pause prayer. Hello, I'm praying. Let me finish praying. I respond to you. I said, Jesus, you are wonderful. 2017 is great. And what's up? Come. Oh, sister, wait. I will respond to you. Are you joking? Are you praying? Shut the phone down. When there was no phone, when there was only landline, our productivity is better. Now they have given us a mobile phone and we are being distracted left, right, and center. The tool that's supposed to help us to be a means of communication is becoming a means of distraction. I'm not saying be antisocial. Your friends, 2017, it is like war, survival of the fittest. You must engage your mind supernaturally to produce kingdom result. And you must get it in the name of Jesus Christ. I say you must get it in the name of Jesus Christ. Thinking room is very essential. It's very essential. Do you know that all the products and services you see, these, before they came into existence, somebody have thought about it, has imagined about it, have they thought about it, this is where it's going to be, before it became reality. Things are being created in the thinking room, not in the production factory line. The men who control what goes on are those who are in the thinking room. Can I tell you something? If physical energy is what men use to produce wealth on earth, boxers, bricklayers, those who work when they are doing this, who have more energy, could have gathered more wealth, more than others. But look at the people that their names are in the Forbes magazine. Those who make use of their head. Say with me, I have a head.
I have a mind.
I will think. I am no different to compare with those men who make it to the list of Forbes magazine. You are not different. The same head. You don't get what I'm saying? Somebody is Asia. You can be Asia tomorrow. Somebody is the one calling Digi Company. The one that is controlling Digi is somebody. Somebody is the one, Maxis. Am I talking to somebody at all? So they don't have two heads. They have the same head you have. So if you can think deep everywhere, don't be distracted and maybe government have a way to help them. When you can think through some ideas, heaven blesses it and creates opportunity for that idea. The problem is that there is no idea you have on table, so who will bless it? God will say, God bless me. God will say, what kind of nonsense prayer is this? Why are you asking me to bless you? Give me raw material to bless so that I can bless. So change your prayer. Don't go to God and say, God, bless me. God, give me an idea that you can bless. Yeah. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When God gives you an idea that is blessed of him, you will rise as a king. And men will come to your rising in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Ideas. 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 Give me a sign if my time is coming to an end so that I won't take so much time. Ideas. Ideas and ideas. Engineering factories of this world will soon fold up. Do you know why? Our generation are not serious with thinking. We are talking. We complain of shabby quality product we see all around. Yes, it is happening because men are not what? Thinking. Sickness all over the place because men are not going to God in place of prayer. Give me an idea that we end these issues. Can I tell you something? 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 There is no difficulty in making money. The only difficulty is that we don't have idea that produces money. When you have ideas that produces money, money will look for you and run to you. You don't believe what I'm saying? Sir, there are multinational companies that are willing to pay CEO millions of dollars just for them to be their CEO. Do you believe what I'm saying? What are they paying for? What are they paying for? The man have a mind that can take the company from where they are to where they are going. They are not paying him because they like his face. They pay him because of ideas he can produce and take the company to where the company is what? Going. Develop yourself in 2017. Increase your value. Increase your worth so that men will pay you according to your what? Value. Sir, if you have a security man in your door, you pay him according to the value of the security man. But there are other security men that you will have. You can't pay him the value of the security man at the door. If you have a bodyguard who follows you left, right, and center, that your life is dependent upon him, you have to pay him well so that other people will not buy him over and use him to kill you. True or false? True or false? So the price you pay the bodyguard cannot be the same price you pay the security man at the gate. The job of the security man at the gate is just to open the door. In fact, one day you can get angry. You will tell the security man at the gate, I don't need you anymore. You go and put automatic gate. You press a button. Gate opens and you enter. You sack the security man. But this bodyguard, you still need him to watch you. So you pay him what? Well. Because of the value he's adding to your life. Yes. Everyone in life, the level of wealth you're experiencing in your life is as a result of the value you are commanding. When you increase your value and think the way God thinks, resources will be following you left, right, and center. Tell your neighbor, I will increase my value. I can't hear you. I will increase my value. I will think like God. I will walk like God. I will believe God. And things around me will change. If you believe it, let me hear your better amen. Our generation is full of noisemakers than thinkers. God does not bless noisemakers. He blesses creative thinkers. Thinkers create instrument that makes noise. So if you're not a thinker, create an instrument that makes noise. Stop that noise. Because it won't produce money around you. Have you ever seen a man going on the road and shouting, making noise, talking, and people call him, you talk very well, let's pay you. Wow, what a talk of morning to night, you're talking. People say, insanity has taken place. This guy is mad. But when they see a man sitting quiet in a place, making use of his mind and putting some things down, say, this guy must be a genius. He will be attracted to you. He will be attracted to you. God is a thinker. You must also be what? A thinker. If God said he's going to bless us in 2017, you must also make up your mind to rise, to be thinking the same way God is thinking. So that all the blessings of the Lord will come upon you. It is not wrong to think. The only place where it's wrong to think is to think on the wrong things. It is not wrong at all to think. But it's wrong to think on the what? Wrong things. Now, for in 2017, you have been thinking on the wrong things. That's where. That's why it landed you where it landed you in 31st of December 2016. Change those things you meditate and think about. Think on the positive side.
Yeah, that's right.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't think on your fear.
Yes, right.
Don't think on your failures.
Yes.
Don't think on your past.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, your past is your past.
Yeah.
I can't hear you, your past is your past.
Yeah.
I can't hear you, your past is your past.
Yeah.
Your past is not your prison because it's your what? Your past.
Yes.
2016 is gone. Thank you. Thank God for your failures. I celebrate your failure, but in 2017, you dare not fail again because it's your past. You must rise to show that you are son of a king. How can you be the son of the King of Kings and you are behaving and living like a man, like a rat? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Can you witness a son of Sultan in any state of Malaysia walking like ordinary? No way. They have rigor. If they can accord them that respect, you, who is son of the King of Kings, you must raise your value, your standard. Think like God. See in his eyes. Believe what he says so that all his supernatural blessing can come to you.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
David came one day and the Goliath was telling all of them how he has defeated all Israel.
Yes.
And David looked at him and said, Goliath, wonderful talker, but not a great thinker. Goliath, you are what? Wonderful what? Talker. But not a great thinker. Because if he was a great thinker, he could have covered that place where there's a little hole that allowed that stone to enter. See, I will pieces everybody. Talkers, they make the greatest noise. And the man who is a great thinker came on board. Pam! His creative imagination was activated. I used to be in the bush, and God has helped me to destroy lion who were deadly more than you. Bam! His imagination was activated. Goliath, your head is off. He was not seeing the head of Goliath on Goliath again. He swingled a stone. Bam! The rest is history. He said, where is the raw material? I said, I'm a thinker. The raw material I used to kill Goliath is in Goliath. He brought the sword. Bam! And cut the head. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. Your head will work in 2017 in the name of Jesus. Your mind will be activated in the name of Jesus Christ. Because you don't need to come 31st December 2017 and say, oh, God has not been faithful. The portal is open. And we must ride to the place of our blessing. Can I hear your better amen? Can I hear your better amen? You see, anything that we genuinely think and conceive in God can be actualized. Can I ask a simple question? Which place is the richest part of the planet Earth? Richest part of the planet Earth. Can somebody help me? Somebody said graveyard. My Smuro wrote that in the book. He said it's graveyard. Who again? Richest part of the planet Earth. As you are sitting. The richest part of the planet Earth is the creative mind that is within a man. Because it's that mind that you have that it can use to produce billions or trillions or dollars, whatever you want to do in life. If this mind is no longer working, they say somebody has gone mental, everything is over. The richest part of this year body is your mind. Make use of it. Make use of it. Make use of it. We read about philosophers, great leaders in the past. They made use of their mind. God minds of the planet Earth are not actually the richest part of the Earth. Your mind is. Because it is your mind that will direct you where the gold mine is and you know what to do with the mind. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Can I say this again? I don't know why Holy Ghost is saying it. It is good to spend quality time in the place of prayer. The reason we spend quality time in the place of prayer is to open the heavens so that we can draw inspiration from heaven. Now, when you have prayed enough, sit, put down things and draw from them. When it comes for you to make decisions in life, you make use of your creative imagination. Yeah. There are some things prayers don't sort out.
Yeah.
When you are prayed, get ideas and use those ideas to work. Now, what is the benefit, sir? What is the benefit, ma? That I prayed to hack into the data bank of heaven to receive data as an inspiration. And after receiving it, I don't use it for anything. What for? There is no way the data will be useful to you except those data are processed. Unprocessed data do not make you great. You receive a prophetic revelation. 2017, the portal is open. God spoke to us in our local church that 2017 shall be our year of supernatural growth. And I begin to tell them, sons and daughters in my church, I say, look, I don't want anybody in 31st of December 2017 say, Pastor, I didn't see this supernatural growth. If you say it, I will slap you. You are the one who caused yourself not to get it. Prepare your ground so that you will begin to download what God has said. Can I tell you something that will boggle your mind? Everything you need to be great in your lifetime are ready and available. Do you believe what I'm saying? Let me see if I can get it in scripture. Matthew chapter 24. Am I right? Matthew chapter 24. Holy Spirit, help me. Sorry, verse, chapter 22, verse 4. Matthew chapter 22, verse 4. Can you read it in your Bible? Because if I read in my own Bible, it will look as if to say it's from my own Bible. Matthew 22, verse 4. 1, 2, 3, go. All things are what? I can't hear you. Somebody say, all things are ready.
All things are ready.
I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, all things are ready.
All things are ready.
Can we really say it as if to say, wait a minute. Tell your neighbor, all things are ready.
All things are ready.
Do like this. All things are ready.
All things are ready.
All things are ready.
All things are ready.
Did the Bible say some things are ready? Did it say some things are ready? He said all. Somebody say all.
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 All things are everything you need to be great in your lifetime. They are ready and available. Latch unto God so that you can pick it up. All things are ready. They are available. All you need is to walk into it. Economy is going down. No, I have a God who is sufficient. I am not depending on the economy of war to know what is going on. I have a God who I live in his economy. Why? Job chapter 5, from verse 17 downward, it says, in the time of famine, my people shall be what? Satisfied.
Amen.
That's how a blessed man think.
Yes.
You don't believe what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In Job chapter 5, it said, in the time of famine, famine can represent economic what? Recession. In the time of famine, my people shall be what? All right, you don't be. Let's, Job chapter 5. Job chapter 5. My people shall laugh. In fact, he said they shall even laugh at famine. Job chapter 5. Are you there already? Look at verse 22. Verse 20 said, in famine he shall redeem you from death, in war from the power of the sword. Verse 22, you shall laugh at destruction. At what? And what? You shall laugh at destruction and what? I can't hear you. You shall laugh at destruction and what? And you shall not be afraid of the beast of what? The earth. You shall laugh at what? Destruction and what? Famine. You shall laugh at destruction and what? Famine. Child of God, what did God allow you to do in the time of famine? It means you will be what? Laughing at them. You cannot be laughing if you don't have more than enough. A hungry man do not laugh at famine. You don't get what I'm saying? It means God has packaged you and prepared you and provided resources for you that in the midst of famine, you have more than enough. When others are complaining, you are laughing. Economy is failing. I know my God whose economy does not fail. Let me run out and go to Australia. No, I don't need to run out. I will prosper in this land.
Yeah.
Okay, New Zealand is opening place. Yeah. This is my New Zealand. Malaysia is my New Zealand. Every opportunity I need, all things are ready in this land. Am I talking to somebody? It is not a time to run away. It is time for you to stand and tell God, the greatest of him is available, and you must reach your destination in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you hearing what I'm saying? How many of you know how to laugh? Can you show me a little bit how to laugh? All right. That's how you'll be laughing in the midst of famine in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, in the midst of famine, my people shall do what? Laugh. He didn't say you shall cry. He said you will do what? Laugh. When you see them, you will laugh, because it won't come near your dwelling place. Do you remember the land of Egypt? One day God got angry and said, I'm going to kill every killables. He raised one angel and asked the angel, go to every door of my people. Put the mark of the blood on the door. When they see the blood, don't enter. As a child of God, there is a mark of God upon your life. Strategically placed by God. That's why the portal is open. The portal is not open for everybody. It's open to God's people. So when you are living under open heaven, when others are crying in the famine, you'll be laughing. And they ask you why. Say, I have a portal that is open. Am I talking to somebody? I have a portal that is what? Open. Your portal cannot be opened with, and you will not be receiving supernatural supply. He said, yeah, you will prosper like no other. Say with your mouth,
this year
I will excel.
I will prosper
like every other thing at all. You will.
Yeah.
Are you believing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I say you will do what? You will.
Yeah.
Because God has said it, and God will establish it. If you're the one I'm talking to, let me hear your better amen. You will excel. Let me try to round off the message. Meditation is a process of connecting to the data bank of heaven. Prayer helps you to gain access. That is hacking into the data bank of heaven. It is processed raw data that makes men great. Database of heaven is open 24 hours for people who are ready to download ideas that will make them to be different in life. Plug in through creative meditation and prayer by the help of the Holy Spirit, so that you won't be complaining as the year is coming to an end. Can I hear your better amen? That your land is full of natural resources does not make you to be a rich nation. It's your ability to know what to do with the natural resources that will transform your nation. All things are ready. Plug in to begin to harness them. Think the way your father has positioned you to think. Stop thinking like a chicken, because you're not a chicken. I tell your neighbor, stop thinking like a chicken. I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor, stop thinking like a chicken. You are not a chicken. You are a man. He created you his image, so you must think like him. If David is so glorious, hey, we are finished. Israel, let's all go home. There is no need again. This guy is so tall, he will kill all of us. The whole Israel could have been annihilated. But he came. He said, no. I once killed a bear. I once killed a lion. I've seen worse economic situation more than this one. Ringgit has gone to 6 before. This is not new. It is normal. I'm coming out better. I'm coming out stronger. That should be your what? Mindset.
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When I came in, I was discussing with the brother that we are talking. So I asked, how many number of these chairs do we have here? I say 100. He said, but there is some other one packed. I laughed. I didn't say anything for that. Do you know why I laughed in my spirit? A set man is not limited by the number he sees now. He has seen the crowd coming and have prepared already for them because they will surely do what? Come. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? He could have said, look, we are just 100. Let me limit myself to 100. He said, no, let's make preparation because my people are about to do what? Come. That should be your mindset. We pray on this ground that the supernatural of God will break forth into this place. Men and women will be coming to pick the knowledge of the glory of God. Their life will change. Their life will transform. God will begin to do sovereign things in this place. If you believe, let me hear a better amen. It will break forth. A day is coming where people will be struggling to sit in some locations. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Do you know why? Men are confused outside. They need to come in and hear what will make us laugh in the midst of famine.
That's right. Yes. That's right.
You're not getting me at all. I say men are confused outside. They need to come in to know. When they see a man laughing in the midst of the famine, they say, why are you laughing in the midst of famine? Everybody is complaining. Ah, we are done. We cannot pay our students' school fees. You tell them, no, no, no. My students are not going to study in Malaysia again. I'm sending them to Oxford. They are going to have a, they say, how do you manage to do it? I have a portal that is open. You don't get what I'm saying? And they say, please, how come your children change? How come your children are transformed? Say, come, let me take you to a place. It is a core school of the spirit where mind of men are changed and transformed through the preaching of the gospel. Yeah. A power of God that know how to change life and transform life. Yeah. And they will come one message like this. Pastor Cyrus will just lay hands on one. Bam! Everything will be over. Say, hey, come and see the man who has told me everything. God is not a God of talkative, he's God of action. Every man he meets, he changes his life. He saw the woman of Samaria. How the woman was busy talking. Asked one or two questions. The woman was, he answered wrongly. Asked again, answered wrongly. That encounter changed the story forever. There is no man that meets God and his life remains the same. You have met God of this house. Your life must change in the name of Jesus Christ. Life must change. I say, your life must what? Change. All things you need to fulfill destiny are available. Can you help me and say this to your neighbor? I have a mind. I can think.
I can process.
Spiritual and supernatural data for my elevation. I say I have a mind of Christ. I can think. I can process data for my supernatural elevation. Any man who can be in a place where God wants him to be and think like him will be a high flyer in life. Let's be on our feet as we begin to push in the spirit world. Are you blessed this evening?
Yes.
Are you sure you are blessed this evening?
Yes.
I'm very persuaded that in 2017, you will experience supernatural growth in every area of your life.
Amen.
You will not be lost when the year is coming to an end. You will know that it's a wonderful year. Do you believe what I'm saying?
Yes.
Sir, it is what you call your year that your year becomes.
Yeah.
If you see it as a failed year, it becomes a failed year. If you see it as a glorious year, it becomes what? A glorious year. Say with me, I live in the place of God's glory.
I live in the place of God's glory.
That's my address.
That's my address.
Therefore,
everything
about me
must
reflect
his glory.
Ma, how can you live in God's house and everything around you will be below the standard of God's house? If I'm God, I will kick you out of the house. When you live in God, everything about you will reflect God. Because I'm sure you will be the answer to the questions of those outside there. Say with your mouth, we are the answer.
We are the answer.
We are the answer.
We are the answer.
They don't know how. But we know how.
We
are bringing many sons to the kingdom. We are bringing many sons to the kingdom. We are bringing many sons into the kingdom. We are bringing many sons. Can we say it together? We are bringing many sons
to the kingdom.
To show them the way. Because the way outside
is failing.
But the way inside
is working.
I have God. Everything about him is working. Everything about my God is working. That's what is going to happen to you in 2017. You will grow in stature, in grace, like never before. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You don't need to take people to Pastor Cyrus. Hey, this person is confused. Automatically, you will know what to do.
Yeah.
And you give the person direction.
Yes.
Because you have God inside of you. Amen. Labor like never before this year to bring men and sons into the kingdom. Work yourself out until you develop a superior capacity, and they will be following you. Please help me. Help me. He said, come, let me tell you the place where I drink this fountain that is making me to grow. Bible said that the righteous like a tree that is planted by the riverside, they produce forth their fruit in this season. Say, whatsoever they do, they prosper. Say, the unbeliever are not so. But you are planted in God. This year, you will think like God. Your idea is changing. Your mind is changing. And all possibility of God is yours. Can I hear your better amen?
Amen?
One prayer we are going to pray, and then I will hand over the microphone. One simple prayer. Lord, let me have supernatural encounter with you this evening that will change my story in 2017.
Amen.
Do you understand that prayer? What was the prayer point? Can we do it again? Lord,
let me have
supernatural encounter
with you
that will change my story
forever.
Can you repeat the prayer? Let me know, be sure that you know the prayer you want to pray. Say, Lord,
let me have
supernatural encounter
with you
on this ground
tonight
that will change my story forever. Open your mouth and begin to cry to God. Push in the spirit wall. Shala tete te. Ya kare re 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 re. Shala tete. Somebody push. Somebody push. Shira re 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 re. Shika re 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 re. Mala tete tete te. Shaka re 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 re. Mambro re 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 re. Yale te 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 te. Shika la de 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 de. Shila de 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 de. Maka le de 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 de. Shika de 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 de. Ma le de 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 de. Shira de 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 de. She thank you, Lord. I pray for you that the counter of Jehovah that is upon you now, we change your story forever.
Amen.
Where all the struggles of life will end.
Yes.
Because you will live and operate in the capacity of God.
Yes.
That will be your witness. That will be your testimony. I pray for anyone under the sound of my voice who are sick in any part of your mortal body, be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. I command that sickness to go in the name of Jesus Christ. I command that sickness to go in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that your mind is open right now. I unblock your mind. Let your creative ability be activated right now. Holy Ghost, activate your mind. Somebody push in the spirit world. Let your mind be activated. Let your mind be activated. I activate your spiritual mind. I activate your thinking pattern. Let your mind be activated. Let your mind be activated. Let your thought be activated. Think like God. Talk like God. Speak like God. Act like God. Believe like God. Let your mind be activated. Let your mind be activated. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we receive this increase that is coming. We receive this increase that is coming. Men and women will begin to locate this place to come and honor and serve God. They will locate this place to come and honor and serve God. Thank you for your God servant that is ministering in Saba. Lord, I decree that the glory of God will be in that atmosphere as a minister. There will be a supernatural testimonies. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. We bless you, we honor you, we give you thanks and praise.